Hello, Pastor Doug, back again with another Bible Brief. Today I want to take a look at Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 13. And it reads, "But the word is very near you, in your mouth and in your heart, that you may observe it." This is a very beautiful, simple verse given by Moses, but there is much in it. Notice what it says, "But the word is very near you." What's the word here? Of course, it's the word of God. And here we've had Moses is proclaiming the law of God to God's people. It is the do's and don'ts commanded by God. And so for the Christian, the word of God is supposed to be near us. And where you come near to the word is not just your personal reading of the Bible, though that's okay. I'm all for that. But it's where the word of God is read, is proclaimed, and is served in the sacraments. Because the Lord's Supper is God's word in visual form that we take and eat. So we go to church on Sunday, on the Lord's Day, and the word is near us, but it's supposed to impact us. It's supposed to be in our mouth and in our heart. Heart here is our very inner being, our mind, our soul, our thoughts, our feelings, that inner being. Because when we speak, we are supposed to speak the things of God. And how do you know that the word of God dwells in you? How do you speak? Because from your heart comes your words, and from your heart and your words come from your actions. And by the way, this in your mouth thing is so important today, because the secularists, those who are antichrist, those who desire us not to follow Christ, want to control language. And I strongly encourage you, speak the way Scripture speaks. Avoid, and this, again, sincere, this is a really important challenge, I think, to give you. Do not speak the way the world speaks. Avoid the psychobabble language, intersectionality and diversity and equity and all these other crazy modern words they come up with. Rather, try to sound the way the Bible sounds. Talk about being godly and ungodly, about righteousness and wickedness. Talk about mercy and judgment. Speak the way Scripture speaks. Because for the Christian, God's word is in our hearts. We believe that Christ is our Lord and Savior and God, and therefore his word dwells richly in us. And therefore we desire to go and be near his word, to hear his word, to hear it preached, and to receive it. And that should come out in how we speak, because how we speak shows us what we believe. And when we're doing that, we may observe it. So brothers and sisters, this little verse has a lot in it. Be near God's word. Be near when it's preached. Be near when it's read. Be near when it's served. Have it dwell in your heart and in your mouth. Sound like it. And from that, go and do it. Well, I hope that helps. As always, Christ's grace and peace to you all. Amen.